present you what we are, doing in our tropical condition in Brazil, applying this tool, the proto NMR spectroscopy, to evaluate Petit Verdot wines. I sent before grapes, but we are just sending the paper of the grapes for a paper. So here I present you the results that we had on Petit Verdot wines from three different soils in São Francisco Valley is the name in Brazil. So I am from the South. Embrapa Grape and Wine is the Brazilian Agricultural Research Corporation, and Embrapa Grape and Wine, we have many other units around Brazil, and our works were developed in Northeast, in Pernambuco State, in the Northeast of Brazil. This is the Northeast, and where we have the Embrapa Tropical Semi-Arid. So, you know that quality wines produced in the world, in Europe, in the Northern Hemisphere, here in the US, in the South, Argentina, Chile, Rio Grande do Sul, I will show you, South Africa, Australia, New Zealand. We are located in this between 8 and 9 latitude of the Southern Hemisphere, San Francisco Valley. We had some regions in the world producing to tropical wines like Venezuela. We have contact and some partnerships with people working in India, Thailand, and Myanmar. So in Brazil, where we are producing wines, the most known region is the South. Serra Gaúcha is the name. In Rio Grande do Sul, we have new projects developed in Santa Catarina, in Minas Gerais, my state where I was born, and in São Francisco Valley. And recently, we start a new region, Chapada Diamantina. We have vineyards being started at 1,100 meters of altitude. So many vineyards that you have in South, where my colleague Jorge Tonieto is developing the geographic indications, and many other regions producing fine wines. So Brazil produces about 300 million of liters of wines per year, and 90% is with Labrusca, which is Labrusca, American grapes, only 10% with vinifera grapes, European varieties. So the vineyard in the region where we developed our work, this is a Portuguese company, this is Global Wines, Down Sul. Only to show you the river, São Francisco River, and this property, they have 250 hectares. You can see here the natural vegetation is the Caatinga. And it's interesting to see here, the vines, our annual average temperature is 26 degrees. So they try, the vineyard, the wineries choose when they want to prune and to harvest. So here you can see one plot of 5 hectares in dormancy, in the winter. Here is the flowering. Here we are harvesting grapes, and here is the dormancy in the same day. We can't see that in other place. So we can do this. Monsanto company, they just bought a field in the region to try to, they are developing OJ GMOs with seeds. Here in the US, they can have one result each 7 years. Over there, they have two times each 3 years and a half. So they have two times more result than here in the US. So it's a tropical condition. This explains these conditions. For example, we have three regions, tropical region, Brazil, Petrolina, Thailand, and north of Minas Gerais, João Pinheiro, and the traditional zones in the north hemisphere, for example, Spain, France, and Germany. You have natural, the harvests are obligatory between July and September, and in our region, we can choose when we harvest grapes. We have only 6 wineries in the region. The biggest of Brazil is Miolo. They have 1,200 hectares in the south, and in our region, 200 hectares. So we have 6 wineries only. They use between 10 and 50 varieties to fine wines. Syrah is most important for red wines, Tempranillo, Cabernet Sauvignon, Petit Verdot, that I will show this work. Chenin Blanc for white, Sauvignon Blanc, about 60 wines are sold. 70% of the wines are sweet muscats, and 29% are reds, and only 1% of white wines. Well, we know we have many colleagues has shown the influence, what Stefano also, the factors influencing grape and wine quality, the climate, the soil, cultivar. We saw that terroir is a combination of these three factors, soil, climate, and human factors. Case Zonovene and his team has shown in this paper the effect very interesting in three different soils, gravelly, clay, and sandy on grapes and wine quality. And the hierarchization, it was the first one, the vintage, followed by soil, and then cultivar. We had made some works to using these two, the proto NMR, when I went, I was in France. So you published this paper where we studied many vintages in Bordeaux with 277 plots in Bordeaux using NMR. This is it was made from grape skins, and you can see here. I don't know if you know what is this tool. We can have many compounds determined in one only analyze. It's very interesting. We can find we validated this technique in Bordeaux for amino. So we have amino acids in this region, sugars and organic acids in this region, and then phenolic compounds. But it's very complex the phenolics. So we determined by HPLC. It's not possible with NMR of 500 megahertz to define it to show which phenolics are in this region. So this we had about 15 minutes to get this spectra, 15 minutes, and we had very good results. So the climate, it was the most important factor to discriminate grape skins from three cultivars, Merlot, Cabernet Sauvignon, Cabernet Franc, in many soils too. For wines, in this using the three cultivars in the skins, we get some results, less than in the grapes, but we had also some results, 15 minutes to get the spectra. And we could, the soil, it was the most important factor as compared to cultivar. You have three very discriminated soils and three cultivars in these conditions. Thanks, Case, for the plot in Cheval Blanc. And here we can find only for Cabernet Sauvignon, Cabernet Franc in 2002. We have these three soil well discriminated, most important that the cultivar. So the aim of this work was to apply the proto NMR and KBMWAC to discriminate samples from three soils in our region. Vines were planted in 2002 on Lyre, Petit Verdot, grafted on 101/14. The clone is from Bordeaux, from Mouton Rothschild. It was a French winery, French person that installed this winery, Chateau Ducos. Our colleagues determined, studied three soils. They found three different soils in six hectares of Petit Verdot that we have. We had sandy clay, another one sandy gravelly, and sandy soil. My colleague Tony Jarbas is a specialist of the soils in northeast of Brazil. So the area is, it was more or less like this. We had a big, about 3 hectares of gravel soil, sandy gravel soils, 1.5 of sandy and 1.5 on clay soil. The wines were elaborated in our laboratory of enology at Embrapa in Petrolina. We have a structure to make. But wines we have made by micro vinification in glass tanks. The proto NMR, it was made in Recife, in Federal University of Pernambuco, using a 300 megahertz. We used in Bordeaux 500. But here we tried to decrease the time. Yeah. We used only 3 seconds to get its spectrum. So we'd like to decrease, to analyze a lot of samples very fast and try to get more information. So three seconds, brought one dimension, brought NMR, and we had about 100 variables, histograms, that we call buckets. It's 0, 0 for ppm. The resonance with water, it was removed and data processed by Statistica. So we analyzed the classical analysis of the wines, and we can see that the sand clay soils, we had, well, the pH is very intense because the two harvests, we have very high pH in the month, October, November, December, and differently of the, it depends on the culture. We have very high pH that is influencing the wine stability. And in this condition, for Petit Verdot, it's a nice cultivar, we had very low pH, high acidity, high quantity of phenolics, most for clay and gravel soil, and sand, and less for sandy soils. Our spectrum obtained in 3 seconds, we had five metabolites. So water that was removed, we had the glycerol, succinic acid, acetic acid, the lactic acid, and the 2-3 butanediol. So few compounds, but very fast analyzed. We applied so the PCA to discriminate the plot, and 67% we got a very nice discrimination on wines. So we had very a lot of results in skins and pulps of this work. It was very nice. The phenolics we did by HPLC, and here by NMR we can see that for these compounds, the samples, it was glycerol and butanediol 2-3 that were markers of these two wines from clay and gravel soils, and the acetic acid, it was a marker for the sandy soil. Well, as conclusion, we can say that Petit Verdot wines present a different enological potential according to the soil type in our condition. Wines from grapes harvested in a clay soil present highest values of alcohol degree, 17, it was very high. We can harvest grapes until 30 bricks. It's crazy. And the pH of the wines was very low. It could be used to be blended with other wines. That one of the problems of the region is pH very high and the low stability of the wines. Phenological of the wines from clay and soil and gravelly present high values than sandy soils. Chemometric is applied on protein MR. It was very useful to discriminate plots. The main compounds identified were butanediol and acetic and glycerol. So I'd like to thank the winery, the Embrapa, the CNPq, Tony Girard, my colleague, our team. We have two technicians and some students of master and doctorate. A few words to invite you to come to Brazil. Greg, I think that you go there, and Benjamin, to participate. We are organizing each 2 years the International Symposium on Tropical Wines. It will be between 19 and 21 October this year. So the others that we had organized with our colleagues from Thailand, Australia, and India next, in China will be the next. And just after, we will have in Brazil this year our 39th Congress of the National Congress of Vine and Vine from of OIV. It's a picture of the region on boat in the San Francisco River. And thank you for your attention.